Peace, God, to all my good people out there, man. We're going to talk about it, man. I seen a great, great, great podcast, man. Hell of a podcast talking about alpha mans and betas. And they were basically talking about how, like, you know what I mean? What is the things that women and men don't like about alpha males and betas or whatever, you know what I mean? And my opinion on this situation, right? I feel like this, right? An alpha male, man, the energy that come off of that type of person, you know what I mean? Like, when you walk in the room, the energy follow you, you know what I'm saying? And I think a lot of times when a woman get with an alpha male, they realize how powerful that individual is when he around other people. And the energy that come from that individual, meaning people attracted to him. And I'm talking about from males to women. And I'm not talking a sexual way, just the energy of the person. It's just people want to be around you. People want to have conversations with you. People want to do business with you. You know what I mean? Because your energy is so, it's shooting on everybody. You dig what I'm saying? And when you walk in the room, man, they know your name. Before you even step 2 foot in that door, they know who you are. A beta man is a person that hasn't identified himself as a man yet. You know what I mean? Hasn't got the characteristics of a leader or somebody that can get up and go make something happen out of nothing. You can have $50 in your pocket and go make some money and bring some groceries back. Type of guy that can make something happen in the rainiest situations and bring light to somebody's life. You dig what I'm saying? And that's what you call the alpha. The things that women don't like about it and men don't like about the alphas is that they, a lot of times, they take their women or the aura of that person of getting so much attention and so much love from everybody around them. It breeds jealousy, envy, hateful things within their heart because they can't be like that, but they can. They're just not identifying the trueness of who they are. See, when you wake up in the morning, you look yourself in the mirror, and you got to realize that the hard work that that individual put in, you could put in the same hard work, and you got to have confidence in yourself and be able to communicate, you know what I mean, articulate with anybody, be able to have any type of dope and amazing conversation with any woman, any guy, any multimillionaire. Like I say, money don't identify the character of the person. It's the character. It's who he is. It's the person that don't have a dollar in his pocket, walk in the room with a bunch of billionaires, and everybody's willing to invest in his company because they believe in him. They see the glow within that person. And then when he gets to that Jordan point or get to that Jay-Z point, you see the shine. You see the legendary status of that person. The offense comes when a woman get with this guy and don't realize how hard and how dedicated that person is into making their life better. And everybody around want a piece of that person. And you have to keep your game up to par to stay near an alpha male because he has options. Yes, a lot of options going to come his way. A lot of opportunities going to come this way. When you step into your glory, can't no man or no item or nothing stop you. When you walk in, I'm talking about when you walking in it, nobody can stop your glow. Absolutely nobody. I'm talking about when Jordan out there shooting them jump shots, winning them rings, he knew in his heart that when I step on that court, they better get out my way because it's going down. I don't give a care who on the court going against me. They're going to have to feel my wrath, and everybody going to talk about me when the game's over. LeBron James, KD, you know what I mean? All these guys, they play their game with their heart on the line. Everybody we see from the Jay-Z's to the Eminem's, you know what I mean? The great ones out there that dedicate their time to being great and being polished men and respectable guys. You know what I mean? Like I told you before, you ain't got to be the biggest dude in the world. You ain't got to be the strongest dude in the world. You got to have motivation outside of the box and willing to push the odds. Not a person that's going to give up on life and sell drugs, rob people, and do harmful things to people. A person that will say, I can see myself on the other side of that gate, and I'm going to get to it. And don't have nothing in his heart that's going to let him stop him. He's looking at his kids. He's looking at his family. And he's going to work hard to get it. That's what he was talking, what Antoine was talking about up there. I hope I'm saying his name right. That's what he's talking about. Is that go-getter mentality. She was talking about, the young lady was talking about, like, what if the guy live in his mother's basement and he can get all the girls on the block? Isn't he considered an alpha man? He's considered an alpha man when he is in high school. Guys that's out there going to get it, they look at him as a joke. Women, real women, look at him as a joke. Women that has not found their glow, they're going to look at him as a successful person to be with, because they haven't identified themselves as somebody special. You know what I mean? And when they do, they're going to realize this wasn't even worth it once they actually get with a real alpha, a man that's out here getting business done and doing it the right way without having to sell drugs, without having to do anything negative. Alpha, to me, is being able to pick up a book, read, study something that you love to do. The guy that stay on the court all day and night shooting jump shots. The guy that's on that football field running laps that can't run no more, man. It's all about the dedication, the heart to it. Every girl in the world dissed you when you was in high school. Now you're going to be a hell of a man. Get in shape. Get your body right. Get your money right. And when they look at you, they're going to regret every day that they let you go. Why? Because your alphaness is going to spread all over them. You know what I mean? They're going to see it. They're going to be like, dang, I never knew what I had before me. You could talk to a woman, right? Let's say multiple alpha. They could talk to a woman. They not even knowing who they talking to or who they with. And to that man walking that room, And she see that energy that comes off of them from all these different people wanting to be a part of his life. You know what I mean? And she see it. It's the pressure that comes from being with an alpha man that put a lot of women in bad predicaments because they can't keep up with the opportunities that's before him. They don't look the same or none of that. Let's go to Derrick Jackson for a minute, right? He went out and started cheating on his wife. Why? Because he had so many options. He got his body right. He got his money up. He got his interests up. And he was able to go out, walk out there, and get any little chick he wanted from Atlanta. Why? Because he became an alpha man. So that's the thing. It's leadership. It's that ability to make something happen out of nothing. That person that you doubted, he'll never be this. He'll never be rich. He'll never be this. He'll never do that. And then this dude becomes so motivated and so powerfully walking in his structure that he started electrifying everybody around him because he's accomplishing goals that everybody said he couldn't do. It's alpha. Alpha is the dog in you. Remember Stephen A. Smith, when he talking about basketball players, a football player, I don't see that dog in him. That dog, that killer instinct, that Kobe Bryant is the fourth quarter. You better put the ball in my hand. It's going down. Is that mentality where I will not lose. You had to drag me off this court because I'm not giving up. Until the bell ring, I'm telling you, you won't have to drag me off the court. And that's what they're talking about. The alphas is that competitive nature that would look the most beautiful woman in the world, that diss them, said all type of bad things, and say, I'm going to get her. And he know he may fail one day, fail another day. Alpha ain't about not taking losses. Alpha's about taking a loss and how you come back from it. And when you come back from it, they're going to remember your name, 50 Cent. Nah, they blackballed 50 Cent. You ain't going to make it here. You ain't going to make it there. They shot him up 9 times. He came back and he told them. He became an iconic rapper doing multiple TV series. He made his legacy because he didn't kill. He didn't give up. It's the alpha in him. He's a dog when it comes to this. And he ain't going to let nobody tell him he cannot win. Same with DMX. All the labels not wanting to put no investment into him. They didn't believe in what he could do. And with DMX say, I'm going to change the narrative. The wave that I'm going to come in with, y'all going to respect it. And not just that. Y'all going to dissect every word and everything that I put on these records. And y'all going to respect it, man. That's all it is, man. The alphas, man, is the difference between the alpha and the beta, man. You know what I mean? Somebody that's okay with being normal or regular, or okay with being not having money, okay with living at their mama house. That's a beta. A real man would kill him in the inside. I'm talking about that alpha spirit. It would kill him in the inside. They had to live in his mama house at 30 years old. It kill him in the inside. They had to take a bus. They kill him in the inside. They had to work at McDonald's. Because the alpha will always say, you need to be an entrepreneur. You need to get onto them books. You need to go to college. You need to do whatever you got to do to make it work for your family. And that's what an alpha is. An alpha is, you ain't going to tell me I'm going to lose. I'm going to put up so much effort that you're going to have to take what I'm going to give you. Period. And when you stand in that room, they're going to put that jacket on, that Hall of Fame jacket on, that Shannon Sharpe. They're going to put the Hall of Fame jacket on you. Why? Because you ain't let near failure dictate who you became in your life. Not a failed relationship, not a loss of job, not nothing. You're going to go get it. You feel me? That's that alpha, man. Salute to all the real ones out there, man. They feel where I'm coming from. I'm out.